The production of plastic waste was increased exponentially past 1950s. Plastic made out of polyester, PVCs, nylon, when they are discarded in the environment, they are under physical, chemical, and biological degradations. Everyone can study the microplastics, but when they became of the 1 microns, we call them nanoplastics. However, we don't have a method to identify them. We lack the tools, and whether they are actually in our body, does that actually cause health issues? That's why we jumped in to try to solve this problem. My name is Beizhan Yan. I'm an environmental health scientist. The goal of my research is characterizing the exponential growth of the plastic waste, including microplastics, nanoplastics, and also the metals, all these kind of the pollutants. And what is the implications in the human health? If they have that impact, then I want to try to develop some of the engineering solution to solve the problem. In order to really understand microplastics, you need to figure out what their source. So the environmental samples, when we go to the field, we collect onto these glass containers, and then we bring back, and then we filter, and then we do the measurement. So the technology we developed to measure the nanoplastics is called the stimulated Raman scattering. We're using these two lasers, and we can measure signals from the detector. After we developed this method, we opened a window to the invisible world to us. But next steps is case studies. So we use the bottled water first. And when we look into the data, we see that nylon and also PVC and also the polystyrene was much higher than we previous thought. We are quite surprised because we thought they are going to already be filtered out by the ultrafiltration. And we find out that the ultrafiltration can remove the particles from the source water. However, they are also shedding the particles into the water that we drink. We don't know the human health yet. However, because it's so small, they can easily get into blood and then get into your organs. So they are being stuck in there. So I'm actually collaborating a lot with environmental health scientists. There, I can tap into the knowledge of disease doing this kind of the exposure and the health outcome studies. Just doing my research is so narrow, and this is a global, huge global issues. Any single research discipline cannot solve the problem. So all these experts need to be in the same room to do the research. For example, laundry wastewater generating huge amount of the microfibers and then can end up in the ocean and in the river. We are right now developing these new filtration techniques to be able to filter out all these particles to remove the fibers before they are getting into the sewage systems. After we answer all these kind of the questions, the results goes to the general public and also goes to these policymakers to see how we can prevent the microplastics and nanoplastics in the water. So that's why I love this place to do the more work on that.